Welcome back. We were able to get a connection now, so we're talking about the Fargo Able Games this morning. It's the Midwest's first all-inclusive test of functional fitness, and this charity event celebrates the abilities of all competitors, from the highly skilled athlete like the one we're going to be talking to in a little bit, to those with special needs.
And joining us today then to give us a little insight into the event, we have Fargo native and New York Jets center Connor McGovern. Welcome, Connor.
Thanks for having me, guys. I really appreciate it. Sorry about those technical difficulties this morning, but we got it all worked out.
That's okay. Looks like you're out in the football field.
Just out next to my apartment. I was having some trouble with some connections and Wi-Fi and cellular data, so I had to go out and try to find some. So.
Oh. Okay, we understand.
Beautiful day.
It looks like it is. We understand
totally
completely.
But thank you for joining us here this morning. We do appreciate it. So just tell us a little bit about the Able Games. What are they?
So the Able Games is going to be an awesome event, hopefully for many years to come and in Fargo. But at the end of the day, it's a great event to allow everybody of any ability to go out and have a little fun, have a little competition. And to also raise awareness for people with special needs in that segment of the population, and truly show off their abilities and show what they can do, and also have a little fun.
Yeah. So how did you come up with the idea for this event?
It was in combination with Kim. You know, Kim Platson over at TNT has done a fantastic job with everything, and we were just kind of discussing ways I could help, and I really wanted to have my charitable time and everything go into something like this. So Kim and I were working on some stuff, and we came up with this idea after I had some friends that compete in the adaptive CrossFit division. So I was like, well, that's more for people with physical disabilities, people with a little bit more special needs. I figured they needed their own competition and arena for them to compete. And we thought it'd be a fun idea to have them compete alongside able-bodied people and just to show how special they are and truly what they can do.
Yeah, that's fantastic. And so at the event, what can we expect to see?
I think at different times you come, you'll see different athletes there, from NFL players to CrossFit athletes to one of my best friends, Miles Montpleasure, the You Betcha guy, MCing, and just a lot of people having a lot of fun competing and completing different physical challenges and doing as fast as they can to try to win some prizes. So it'll be a great time and a great competition and a great way to raise some money and have some fun after everybody's been cooped up with the winter and COVID.
So, Connor, I have to ask, what is one of your personal favorite parts of this? Kind of what's the feeling that you get when you are there or when you're putting this together?
The biggest part to me is just allowing people with special needs to showcase what they can do. So I got my start with it in college with helping out with the Special Olympics. And they have in Missouri, they had a powerlifting meet. And the first time I was there, I was helping load weights and spot, and when I saw the first athlete come up, she couldn't really even walk to the bench. Her coach helped her to the bench, helped her get situated on the bench. She unloaded the bar, and then she started lifting an incredible amount of weight with perfect form, and you could just see the change in her demeanor, just like any athlete. It was go time. It everything went from big smiles and cheering and happy to she was locked in, focused, ready to go. And every athlete that competed that weekend was the same way. And, I didn't have a lot of experience with this, people with special needs, and to be able to, see them, go into, competition mode, it was pretty special. And, so I wanted an outlet, they had another outlet to go out and get into that zone and compete. 'Cause I've been fortunate enough to, make a living on competition and getting into that zone. And, without it, I probably wouldn't be here talking to you guys today. So competition and doing what you love is incredibly, special to me and been huge in my life and my career. So I just want to give that outlet and, and for those people.
Really great story. And we're being told we have to go, but really, really quick, if you can people still sign up, and where should they go?
Yes, they can sign up at theablegames.org, or they can go to the TNT Fitness website and sign up there, or for volunteering or competing, you can also call TNT Fitness and go about it that way. Right. So there's multiple outlets and there's multiple jobs. So I really appreciate you guys.
Yeah, right. Thank you, Connor.
Coming up here on today's show, a new fishing team at Cheyenne High School will tell you what it's all about coming up next.